What's up, everybody? Thanks for tuning back in for another one of these videos. I'm back out in the same place where I did my last video with the cemetery camping. This is a hunting preserve, so I got the orange hat. And man, you can see that the spring is in full force here. Sunset looks pretty cool. And after I did the last video where I camped using an emergency poncho as my shelter, I thought, what other kind of improvised shelters could I do without going through like an all-day process of building like a big hut and kind of bushcrafty kind of shelter? So today I am going to be camping with one of those generic blue Home Depot tarps, and we're gonna see how that works out. Hoping for the best. There is a prediction of some rain tonight, so fingers crossed not gonna be too bad, but if it is, we're gonna make sure we're nice and secure in there. So I will get back with you all when I have a spot picked out. I was starting to get a little nervous because I wasn't sure when I was gonna find the spot that I had scoped out before. But it looks like I found it here. This is what we want. Really gets to a point where it opens up back in here. Yeah. This will be great. This will be home for the night. And over there is the trail. I don't know how well you can see. There's where I walked in, right there. But it's really overgrown right there at the beginning next to the trail, so it kind of hides kind of what's back in here. So I'm gonna find a place and set up, and I'll start filming again when I do. Okay, this is gonna be home for the night. Gonna run the tarp right between these two trees. And get camp set up here. Okay, I'm sure if you watch camping videos on YouTube, probably seen these knots before, but if you haven't, this could be useful for you. We're doing a Canadian jam knot on this side. So just have a regular knot here. You take the rest of the end underneath this knot, tie another knot around the long end. Make sure that this knot is on the outside of the new knot you tied. Pull that guy down. That ain't going nowhere. And then on this side, we're gonna tie a taut line hitch. There's different ways to do it. I'll show you what I do. Two on the outside, one on the inside. Tie it back to itself like that. It should be 1, 2, 3 bumps with this one coming out on one other side. Now you can tighten it, you can loosen it, but it doesn't come loose when you tie on it. So now we have an adjustable knot. These are the two basic knots that you really need. The two basic knots that you really need that get you through most situations. Make a bite, just like that. That goes through the tarp. We'll stick a little stick, or like a toggle, some people like to call it. Now, it's pretty sturdy, but you can move it down. Tighten up the tarp. I need two stakes for the back. I'm gonna use a stick that is just big enough to fit into this hole because I want it to be nice and snug. Just carve that out to a point. Boom. Boom. Got a couple of tent stakes. Okay, in order to really get the versatility out of a tarp, I find you really need at least a center tie-up point. I've kind of eyeballed the center point. I'm going to use a rolled up piece of paracord. I put it in, make a ball like that. Take my cord. Tie it off. Stake it down here. Mismeasured that just a little bit. That's hopefully enough room. Take that out. Then we can use this to pull it out a little bit. Oh, goodness gracious. Okay. stake that point out. And we can use this tie out point to just give ourselves a little bit more room. Got that same Saffy Rose emergency tarp. If I can get it out of there. Okay, that's looking pretty good. Looks like I need to pull this just a little bit down this way. I got room from the rain here. And I've got room from the rain here. I should be good. So today, oof, really in a rush. It's a Friday while I'm filming. I came here directly from work. I have been going gangbusters, trying to get this set up while I still have enough daylight. Still gotta get a fire pit set up and a fire started. And then we're gonna cook some sausages, but gotta take a break for the banana flask. One more. That's a monkey shoulder. Monkey shoulder bourbon. This is just some super punky wood that I found back here. It's got fungus growing on it. In place of, if there's no stones around, sometimes the best you can do is to just wall it off with some logs. Then you watch that, it at least keeps stray embers from going all over the place. Thank you. little trick I learned watching Coal Cracker Bushcraft. Obviously that's a big channel, so if you're watching mine, you've probably seen his. Using the edge of your saw, really throw some big sparks there. And we got a fire. Fire. That ain't moving. Okay, but I am gonna show a quick and easy way to process up some firewood, especially your fuel, your little stuff you can break with your hands. Easy enough. I do have a saw, but I'm running out of time. So what we're gonna do is go between the Y branch here. Hopefully you can see that. Boom. 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 You know, like literally 10 seconds, I got this much fuel. It's not enough, but or it's not a ton, but 5 minutes in. Well, I'll show you what I got. Just a couple minutes I got that. It's hard to kind of give you the diameter, but it's about as big as you can get away with. And it's not super solid. But I also just have plenty of firewood around, which of course I will be extremely careful with. But I don't think I'm gonna run out of a shortage. But as you can see, the sun is basically set and I still gotta put together a hot dog skewer. Rheinheist Bubbles Rosé Ale. Cincinnati made. Good morning, everybody. Boy, it is a little chilly this morning, that's for sure. Never got any rain last night, so didn't really get to test out exactly how well the tarp worked, but definitely felt nice and cozy. Slept perfectly fine under there. So ran into a little bit of an issue last night. I shoot these videos on my phone. My phone died in the middle of filming. I hooked it up to the charger, but it wouldn't film again until it got back. Until it got back to a certain level of charging. So I had to wait for the phone to charge. So while the phone was charging, which seemed like it was taking forever, I got into the sleeping bag, and next thing I knew, woke up in the middle of the night. I was not hungry to cook up these sausages. So I did make up that kind of homemade hot dog skewer last night. So I'm going to have one of these cheddar sausages for breakfast this morning. Make a super quick fire and cook that up, and then tear down camp, and then I'll be on my way. I just want to say I really appreciate everybody coming along on the ride with me. Everybody watching the channel, it really means a lot. I appreciate it very much. And I want to send a quick little shout out to a couple very special subscribers that I know tune in for all the videos, and that's Levi and Noah Rotroff. I appreciate you two checking in with me and watching the videos, and I hope to see you soon. And for everybody else on YouTube, catch you on the next one.